Members, the House has resumed. Before the dinner break, we were debating the third reading of the Commerce Amendment Bill, and the Honourable Christopher Finlayson had 8 minutes and 8 seconds remaining to speak, should he so wish to do so.
Madam Speaker.
I call Clayton Mitchell.
Madam Speaker, before the break, I had the great pleasure of listening to 2 whole minutes of what I considered a ballerina dancing around the head of a pin, trying not to give any credit where credit was due on a bill, the Commerce Amendment Bill, because, of course, giving credit to this government that is now 12 months in and going so well certainly couldn't possibly be done. So it was quite a nice little wee twinkle toes around the subject without actually getting into the nuts and bolts of it. I'm going to be taking a relatively short call this evening on this bill, but I was in the House yesterday through the Committee of the Whole stage when I had the pleasure, or some may say displeasure, of listening to some of the comments that were made from the other side. And anyone listening might have actually thought that these people were going to be opposing this bill tonight. But no, alas, they're in full support of it, but they were loving the throwing of the stones and the muck. So we'll just hit it back to you guys. But great stuff. Look, it is fantastic. This bill does do everything it's designed to do. It is great that the opposition are in support of this bill, despite some of the comments that were coming out yesterday. Look, you don't have to be a politician or a rocket scientist to work out the many things that have been going wrong in this country and have been going wrong for a very long time in relation to the cost pressures around the cost of living, particularly, Madam Speaker. We've talked about, and in fact, it was Judith Collins who spoke quite considerably specifically on the petrol pricing in this country. In fact, the cheapest, just to segue for a second, the cheapest petrol prices we've got at the moment is in the Waikato, in this tiny little town, I think it's Ahapurunui, something like that, I'm not sure. And anyway, it's like $2.07 a litre. And they're the only petrol station in town, they've got no competition, and they're Atiamuri. That is Atiamuri. Thank you. Thank you, Minister. Atiamuri, the cheapest petrol in the country. Now, they've got no pressures of other petrol stations around them to get that, but they are delivering the cheapest petrol in the country. And when you compare to the prices that we are paying now in and around our large centres and cities, even in Tauranga, I mean, I drive a diesel, a very good diesel, not one of those dodgy ones. And the price of diesel's doubled. It's not doubled. It's gone up by 50 cents. This time last year it was $1 a litre, and now it's $1.50, or just under. And petrol, Madam Speaker, has gone up astronomically, despite a 3.5-cent increase with excise, which some people are suggesting that that's the reason for the rapid increase. The cost pressures and the way that some of these fuel companies are behaving is exactly what this bill will go and address. But it's not just the fuel companies. We've had discussions around the issues specifically to do with supermarkets and the costs around the supermarkets, the price of living, and the monopolies and duopolies that are operating in this country, and giving the power of the Commerce Commission to go in and have a look at some of those things. I've got a list here. Apart from the supermarkets and the fuel prices, we've got energy and gas pricing. We pay over the odds for our gas and our energy in this country. The building and construction sector, with costs just going up through the roof. There's no such thing as an affordable home. I've built recently a very small, modest 118 square metre home with my wife, and the cost was over $500,000 for the build, and we've just got chipboard floors. Well, we haven't got all chipboard floors. We don't even have a garage. But the costs going through these building companies are just out of control. And these are the sorts of things that we could get our Commerce Commission to take a serious look at. The scope of work that they've got and the ability to check that out with the airlines, the bank charges, when you compare the charges and the credit card charges that we pay in New Zealand versus what they're paying in Australia, remembering, Madam Chair, that most of our banks are owned by those foreign monopolies and duopolies in Australia. And so to hold them to account and hold their hands to the fire is exactly what this bill will enable the Commerce Commission to do. And something that's quite dear to my heart and something that we've talked about as a party quite considerably, in fact, it came up as a remit at our recent convention in Tauranga, was about the cost of retirement villages and the disparities and differences between one retirement villages and another. And I think those are the sorts of areas that we could be spending some time, some effort, some energy into making sure that we get those settings right and enabling the Commerce Commission with the right tools to deal to these sort of situations, I think, will go a long way for all New Zealanders. We are a very expensive place to live when you look around the world. In fact, I've got family in the UK that pop down and get £20 worth of groceries, and they've got four bag loads of groceries, whereas here you go and spend $40 of groceries and you won't even have enough to feed your kids for the night. You'd be better to go down to McDonald's or get some fried rice from the local Chinese takeaways, because it's just so expensive to buy groceries in this country. The airport regulations are another great opportunity. Three main parts of this bill: giving the Commerce Commission the tools, enabling them to have reviews, and looking at the way the airport regulations and airport services can behave, I think is a great thing. And it's very, very pleasing to see the House as a whole come together to support this bill as we steward it through the House. And tonight, the third and final reading. So look out, New Zealand. We've got some good things on its way. Another great thing that this government has achieved in a very short amount of time, and it looks like they're all ready to take a call. So on that behalf of New Zealand First, I recommend the bill to the House, and I'll take a seat. Thank you.
I call Alistair Scott.
Thank you, Madam Speaker, for this opportunity to...